Good evening, my sisters. This is, of course, Big Boo Butch. I'm here with all my dogs. They're very interested in what I'm doing, so I don't know how long they'll stay, though, because I don't think they're into radical feminism. Are you Kipper? This is Kipper. She is my Minpin Chihuahua. Oh, that's Jack. Hi, Jack. He's one of my Taiwanese mountain dogs. Flew here straight from Taiwan. You're getting a glimpse of Casey, my Minpin wiener dog. I don't think they're going to let me do this video. Okay, guys, let me do this video. Sally is waiting patiently with her ball because she wants me to throw it. She's my other Taiwanese mountain dog. All right, so. I had someone bring up intersectional feminism the other day. Hi, Casey. Stay down, baby. In regards to trans women, right? And that really, really pisses me off. As a lesbian, it pisses me off. If I were a woman of color, it would piss me off even more. You know, because intersectional feminism has nothing to do with trans women. It is about the way subsets of women deal with their own oppression inside the feminist movement. And since male transgenders are not women, and holy crap, they're not oppressed in any way, shape, or form. Even when they think they pass, it's because people don't pay attention. Because I pass as a man until people actually look me in the face and realize that, oh, my bad, you're a woman. My bad, Ms. Wolf. Come on down. You know, so they're not oppressed. They're not a subset of women because they are not women. So they have nothing. Really want me to pet your belly, don't you? So they have nothing to do with intersectional feminism. And it really pisses me off that libfems, their male transgenders, handmaidens, I call them sheeple. It really pisses me off that they're all about, you know, trans women and intersectional. I'm an intersectional feminist. Someone tried to gain entry into one of my groups. And she said that I'm an intersectional feminist, so you probably wouldn't want me in this group. So I explained to her what intersectional feminism actually was. I even looked it up and gave her the actual definition of intersexual feminism. And explained to her just basically what I just explained to you. And yes, Casey, I love you. You are my girl. And all she said was, all she replied with was trans inclusive. So I was like, all right, when you hit peak trans, you come find me. And that was the end of our conversation because you can't talk to the handmaidens. You really can't. Our conversations with male transgenders and their handmaidens aren't really about them because they're entrenched into the cult, the cult of gender, the cult of transgenderism. It's a cult. It really is a religion. Because if you don't believe what they believe, then you are ostracized. You are called a TERF. You're called a bigot. You're called transphobic. And, TERF is a slur. B, they're using the word bigot wrong. They apparently don't know what that means because we don't hate them for their opinions. They hate us for our opinions. Yes, baby. You sure do. They hate us for our opinions. Our opinions that men and women cannot change their sex and that gender should be abolished. Those are our opinions. And they hate us for that opinion. They want to harm us. They want to dox us. They want to find out where we work and call our work and harass our work. They want to email our family and harass our family. You know, they want to find out where we live and I don't know what they do when they find out where we live. I mean, you know, come on over to my house. I have guns. I'm not afraid of you. I don't give a shit. But what are they going to do? Put a bag of poop on my doorstep and light it on fire and knock and run away? Is that their intent when they find out where we live? You know, they're cowards. They're cowardly men sitting behind computers trying to feel special because their life is so unbelievably ordinary and they are so obscure that they need to feel special. So they go online to find that. And they find women, lib femmes, who are willing to give them that attention, that affection, that acceptance. Even when they're, you know, saying that, you know, when they're a bearded man, not wearing women's clothes or makeup or anything like that, and they call themselves non-binary. They're a non-binary woman. They're challenging the roles of gender. No, you're not. You're just a dude claiming to be a woman. That's all you are. Girls don't fight now. They're not non-binary. They're not gender non-conforming. I'm gender non-conforming. Okay, butches. We are gender non-conforming. I met a woman a week or two ago who I thought was a butch, but she's straight, and she's gender non-conforming. You actually meet a lot of gender non-conforming women in the Midwest. It's, my gaydar is off since I got back to the Midwest, because you got all these farming women, you know? I saw one the other day. I thought she was this cute, sporty dyke with her hair and a ponytail and wearing her work boots, and she was picking out lettuce, and then I saw her with a dude, and I was like, damn, she was cute. You know what I mean? Not that I would go up to her. I don't do that sort of thing anymore. But it's funny living here in the Midwest. You know, your gaydar, you know, and then all the hipsters running around, because I live like 25 minutes away from a major university, U of I, part of the Big Ten. Sally, it's okay, baby. It's just the neighbors. Baby. It's just the neighbors. Sally. Good girl. Get your ball. Let me throw your ball for you. Come on, put it down. Spit it out. There you go. All right, you ready? Go get it. Can you get it? I just threw it and it landed in the bookcase shelf, so I gotta go get this ball. Hang on. I'm sorry. I keep making these one in a million shots. Right before I started, I threw it into the lamp, and it just stuck between the lamp and the wall, and she didn't know how to get it, so I had to help her out. We throw it in the kitchen. There's nothing in there. So I don't remember where I was because menopause, and I don't know where I was going. Oh, I was talking about the Midwest and butches and how we're gender nonconforming. These men who claim to be women are not gender nonconforming, especially the ones who dress up in women's clothing and wear makeup and have long hair and shave their face three or four times a day so they don't have any stubble. These are, I was going to say gender conforming men, but I don't really believe that gender is a thing. But what they do is they take sexual stereotypes of the opposite sex and they take on all of those stereotypes and then they call themselves the opposite sex. That's not non-binary. That's not gender non-conforming. That is completely conforming, strictly adhering is what I call it when I talk to people online, strictly adhering to the sexual stereotypes of the opposite sex. And the guys who are, you know, full facial hair and short hair and, you know, no dresses, no makeup, no, either just a guy claiming to be a woman online. They're just trying to feel special. You know what I mean? In a world where most of us don't feel special. Excuse me. And we watch TV shows and movies where people get to feel special because they're heroes or whatever. And we're in our ordinary lives, you know, working out of cubicles or, you know, things like that. And we're not doing anything special. So they want to feel special. They're sitting in their, probably in their mom's basement, getting off on the lib femme women, telling them that they're women and telling them that they're special and catering to them and defending them and fighting other women for them. I mean, it's an MRA movement, ladies. Come on. Sorry, I used the term ladies, but whatever. I'm sorry, I drifted off from my original point. Now I don't know where I'm at. I do that a lot. Menopause. I blame everything on menopause. So that was one point I wanted to make. I have an email here from myself. It was actually a response to a male transgender who was trying to shame a woman. She's a friend of mine now. We met in real life and had sandwiches and sundaes together. And he was trying to shame her. He was on her friends list. And she came out as gender critical and posted something. I don't even remember what she posted. It was a meme about something. maybe about prostitution or something. And so, coward that he is, he went to his own Facebook and complained about her and bitched about her and moaned about her and how horrible it was and how horrible she was and how disappointed he is. And then he tagged her because he's a coward. He can't go to her page on her post and complain. You know, he's got to go to his page and then tag her so that all of her friends get to see the post. So, of course, I had to respond because he was being a dick. You know, I got to respond to that. So that was one of the things we talked about. I talked about was that, you know, he absolutely lives by very restrictive gender standards because he was claiming to be non-binary or gender non-conforming or something. So, and I told him that biology is not the social construct. Gender is. Gender is a social construct. Biology is real, folks. I'm sorry that interferes with your delusions. Some of them even worse than delusions. I'm sorry that interferes with your delusions and your obvious mental illness, but biology is a real thing. Sex is real. There are two sexes. That's it. There are variations on those two sexes, but that does not make them 3, 4, 5, 1,000 sexes. It makes it two sexes. Hi, Jack. With variations on those sexes. Are you going to give me a kiss, big boy? Yeah, he's my lover. He's my mediator. When the girls fight, he gets in the middle and breaks it up. And gives them all kisses on their face. He's so sweet. So it's, you know, biology is not the social construct. I think they're confused about what a social construct is. Do you know what I'm saying? I don't think they know what a social construct is. Hi, Kippers. My little Kipper. What else did I say? Oh, he was talking about, I think he talked about how there are, or maybe somebody in his comments talked about how there are no women that have been harmed by male transgenders in the bathrooms, which is a complete lie. A complete lie. I mean, I can point you to a website where they have, I love you, where they have news story after news story after news story about male transgenders harming, even killing women in bathrooms, changing rooms, shelters, women's shelters, jail cells. You know, they let a man who claimed to be a woman in a jail cell with another woman. He raped her and killed her. So yes, it happens. And women have real concerns. And shaming us into silence is not going to make those concerns go away. We're just going to talk about them with each other and try to make changes a different way. I won't be shamed because I know. I was petting her belly and then I stopped. And so she put her paw up to get me to help. Keep petting my belly. So we have real concerns. And the thing that gets me is that these male transgenders are allowed to have concerns about male violence. You know, they don't want to be in the male restrooms because of male violence. Well, why aren't women allowed to have those same concerns? You know, male transgenders have the ability to be just as violent as non-male transgenders, as other males. That's been proven in a study, you know, and they're just as violent. They have the capacity to be just as violent as other males, and yet we're being forced to share private spaces with them in vulnerable states, in, you know, half-naked or naked states. And that's just, it's unacceptable. If they're allowed to have concerns, why aren't we allowed to have concerns? You know, estrogen does not make you nonviolent. You know what I mean? It's not going to change a man into a woman, and it's not going to change a man from a violent man into a nonviolent man. There are plenty of men on estrogen online who talk about killing us. So it doesn't make them nonviolent. It just makes them grow tiny little vests and their dicks shrink. That's all. When I posted that link, it was, that bar, that no platform thistle. And, we all went over there and gave them bad reviews and commented on the post about him canceling all of her shows. And so, of course, I got attacked by male transgenders and their handmaidens and how awful I was. Oh, even straight men. Some straight guy was like, I'm so disappointed in you. And I was like, I don't give a fuck what you think. You're just some dude online. Why the fuck would I care if you're disappointed in me? Who gives a shit what you think? You dumbass. So I was, you know, I was trying to explain to them that, yes, it does happen. And yes, we are in danger of being hurt. And they wanted proof, of course. And it took me more than 2 minutes to find the proof. So it was a handmaiden. She was demanding proof. I think it was. It might have been a male transgender. I didn't check the profile, but they had a female name. So who knows? Who knows anymore online? But they wanted proof, and they didn't give me more than like a minute and a half to get the proof before they commented back and said, see, you don't have any proof, so you're lying. You know what I mean? And so I came back with Allison's Law. It's, for those who want to look at it, it's allisonslaw.wordpress.com. And of course, the first several, you can do a search for, like, if you do a search on there for bathrooms, it'll show you news articles from women who were attacked in bathrooms by male transgenders. But I just showed them, I just gave them the link to the WordPress itself. And of course, one of the male transgenders came back and started complaining that cross-dressers are not male. You know, they're not trans women. They're not women. Well, A, you don't know how they identify. I mean, if we are supposed to allow you to self-identify and we can't call you men, then you can't call a cross-dresser a man. You can't self-identify for him. You don't know how he identifies. You only know how the papers identified him. And two, don't you find it interesting that when something bad happens to a male cross-dresser, the trans community, you know, gathers around him and, oh, he's transgender and he's part of our community and we need to protect him and stand up for him, blah, 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 right? Because under the umbrella of transgender is cross-dressers, so. But when they do something bad, when cross-dressers do something bad, they all jump up and say, he's just a cross-dresser, he's not a trans woman, he's not trans. You know, you can't blame us for him. You know, they're all stupid. But I want to finish with this because I'm at 18 and a half minutes. I want to finish with this. And I probably should have started with this because I don't know how many people are going to stick with me the whole 20 minutes. But I'm really tired of being called a bigot and being told that I hate transgenders. I don't hate transgenders. I don't wish them any harm. Unlike them, they wish us harm every day. Every day. They want to dox us and cause us harm, get us fired. None of us do that to them. I don't wish them any harm. I don't wish them to be discriminated against. I would like to see laws put in place so that they're not discriminated against and they're not harmed, etc., etc. They actually have more protections than I do as a lesbian. Because they have federal protections, whereas I do not. But I don't wish them any harm. What I don't like is gender. Gender is abhorrent. It is a cancer. It is a cult. And it is a terrible, terrible construct that we created to further oppress women and to really keep people in their place. That's why we have the gendered toys and gendered cards you know, greeting cards and gendered clothing. And all of these things are gendered so that we can keep people in specific boxes. And I hate gender. I think it needs to be abolished. Because if gender were abolished, then people like me would be able to be who I am, wearing men's clothing and having short hair without being assumed to be a man. And people like male transgenders would be able to wear dresses and wear makeup and like pink and like frilly things and have long hair, but still be men. Because what they don't understand is that it's okay to be a gender nonconforming man. I know it's hard in this society because males who are gender conforming hate feminine men. That's what they hate. It's not misogyny that makes men attack other men who claim to be women. It's not misogyny. It's the hatred of the feminine man. The hatred that they're not a normal man. That's what it is. It's not misogyny. Misogyny is the hatred of women, not the hatred of feminine things or feminine people. So I know it's hard in this society, but if we were able to abolish gender and raise our boys to accept women as actual human beings, and respect us as actual human beings, maybe we could do away with porn, with prostitution, gender. We could do away with all of these things. And women might finally have liberation from the patriarchy. That's our goal. Our goal is not to harm transgenders. Our goal is to liberate ourselves and other women, even women who don't agree with us, even women who have not hit peak trans yet. Yet, they will. Because all male transgenders turn on women eventually because they hate us. They hate us for who we are. They hate us for what we have. They hate us for our bodies. They hate us. And they will turn on every single one of us eventually. So you'll hit peak trans, ladies. You will. And when you do, come find me. I've got a couple of groups that you might be interested in. So I'll end there. I'm sorry. It was 22 minutes. I hope that's not too long for you guys. But it's been a while since I made one of these. It's been about a month, month and a half. So thanks for sticking with me, and I'll see you on my blog. Okay? Peace out.